mambo, mambo Italiano. Hey, hey, mambo, mambo Italiano. Go, go, go. You mixed up a Siciliano. All you Calabrese do the mambo like a crazy with the hey, mambo. Don't wanna tarantella. Hey, hey, mambo. No more mozzarella. Hey, mambo.
Hi everybody, I'm Chef Norm, and it's been a while since I made a cooking video, but my wife is out of town. She went to a bridge tournament, and she bought me some chicken at the grocery store to have for one of my dinners. So, I looked through my recipes, and I said I'm going to do something tonight called chicken scallopini with a fontina cheese, prosciutto, and marsala sauce. You might ask, what is a scallopini? A scallopini is a thin piece of meat. It's an Italian dish and it's made with a sauce. And I'm gonna show you how to make a simple one. It doesn't take a long time. I think you're gonna like it. The first thing you're going to do is you need to prep up your chicken. Marianne bought me some thin sliced chicken cutlets, actually chicken breasts. And those are very good to use if you don't have the tools, you don't have the time, and you want to do it a little quicker. If you don't have the cutlets sliced thin like that, the option is to go out and buy some chicken breasts and get a big Ziploc bag. And you put the chicken breasts in the Ziploc bag. And you always have to wash your hands when you're working with chicken, remember. And it's real easy. You take a meat pounder and you can pound your meat down a little thinner. These are already pounded down, so I'm not going to do them very thick. Thin. And the option is, if you don't have a meat pounder, you take a pan. That'll work. Okay, I'm just about ready to get started on my chicken here. I have the thin sliced chicken. I'm going to season with a little bit of salt and pepper here. And you always have to do both sides because the meat doesn't come seasoned on the other side. So, put some more chicken salt on the chicken. A little more pepper on there. That's enough of that. Then, my oil is getting hot in my pan here. I need to turn the fan on, and I just put my apron on because I forgot. One of the biggest mistakes I should have done was I forgot to put my apron on. My chicken's all ready to go. I'm gonna dredge it here in a little bit of flour. And it's gonna go in that hot oil and start to cook. I have four pieces. It's gonna be plenty for me tonight. What you wanna do is cook this chicken till it becomes a golden brown. And it looks like I'm not gonna have enough room in my pan to do all four pieces because you don't want to crowd meat in a pan. If you do, it's going to steam the meat and it needs room to breathe and cook. So rather than try to get this one piece in there, I'm going to wait, get the other ones cooked. It's not going to take very long. Only going to take about 2 minutes or so on each side. And then we're going to take it out and I'll show you when I'm ready to do that. My chicken's just about where I want it to take it out of the pan, and I probably could have pounded them down a little thinner, but it's okay. They'll be fine. A little fancy flipping right there. Now, I'm going to take the chicken out of the pan and put it in a little cookie sheet. A minute, and then I'm going to put them in the oven just to keep them warm, the lowest temperature I can put it on in the oven, just to keep them the way I want them. Okay, my next step is to take some butter and put it in the pan I cooked the chicken in. I have some shallots, or if you want to, you can call them shallots. Depends on what TV show you watch on the food channel. They're cut up real fine. And I have some sliced mushrooms, just white mushrooms. And I'm going to put those in the pan, about a medium heat. They need to cook for about 2 or 3 minutes. You don't want to get the mushrooms overdone or real soggy. So as soon as these are ready, I'll let you know. Okay, we're back to cooking. What I want to do now is, here's my pan. I'm going to deglaze the items that are cooking in the pan with some Marsala cooking wine. This is like a red wine you can buy at the grocery stores. It's easy to get. And you want to use about a quarter of a cup, not a whole lot. I don't really care to drink that wine, but I like cooking with it. And then you want to put some chicken stock in here. That's about 3/4 of a cup. I try to use better than bouillon. It's a paste and you mix it with some water. 1 teaspoon equals like the same thing as a bouillon cube. But if you don't want all the liquid, you can use some of this paste and it gives you the flavor and the seasoning, not all the liquid, which comes in pretty handy. So now this is starting to simmer pretty good. I'm going to turn it down. I want to reduce it slightly because I'm going to pour it over my sauce and the chicken in a few minutes. Okay, now we're really cranking. I've got my chicken cutlets here ready to go. And what I'm going to do is I have some chopped sage and I'm just going to sprinkle a little bit on each piece down here. Not a whole lot. And then you want to top each piece of chicken with some prosciutto, which is like a ham. It's an Italian ham. One for the chicken, one for the cook. Oh boy. Good prosciutto is excellent. Doesn't have to be real heavy. I've just got enough on here. And then the next thing is fontina cheese. If you can get it in your deli, it's good to have them slice it for you. If you can't, you'll have to buy it in those blocks and it's a little harder to slice up. So, you put some fontina cheese on each piece of the chicken. Oh boy, this is going to be good. Darn it, I have some cheese left over too. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is my sauce is cooked down a little bit. It's not going to be a real like gravy sauce or anything, but it's a sauce that's going to cook in the chicken. So I'm going to pour this over my chicken pieces. I'm going to come back and get my camera and take a close-up picture of this plate before it goes into the oven. Then it's going to go in the oven for 400 degrees for 10 minutes. Don't forget to preheat your oven. Mine's just about ready. Oh boy, doesn't that look good? That's going to go in the oven in just a few minutes. I'm just waiting for the chicken to finish up in the oven and then I'll be plating it. And when you go to the market, remember, it's Italian. It's prosciutto. Prosciutto. Mm. That's so good. Salute. Okay, it just came out of the oven and I'm getting ready to plate it and we'll be ready to sit down for dinner in a few minutes without my wife, Marianne. Darn. Must admit, it's a little quieter here without my fan on, but when you're cooking, you have to have the fan on. Okay, the meal is about ready to plate, and just like Chef Ramsay, bring it up to the service area. Oh boy, this looks really, really good. I'm going to put a little bit of the mushrooms on too, scatter them. And I'm going to be serving this with some steamed broccoli. Have a little bit of a garnish of some fresh sage out of my wife's garden. And I'm going to put this on the table and you're going to see it in just a second. Okay, it's about time to enjoy my dinner that I've cooked. It didn't really take a long time. And it looks absolutely delicious. I put a little bit of broccoli on the side. I have some salad to go with it and a little vino. So, chin chin, salute, bon appetit, and Marianne, I wish you was here. Oh, now I don't really wish you were gone, because now I have to do the dishes. Oh well. I forgot to mention that this is really good. I learned this recipe from Chef Bobby at Fraps in Ormond Beach. I took one of his cooking lessons, learned a lot, and I really enjoyed doing it. If you ever get a chance, take one of those lessons if you're in Ormond Beach. Bon appetit. Thank you, Bobby.
Hey, Mambo. Mambo Italiano. Hey, hey, Mambo. Mambo Italiano. Go, go, go. You mixed up a...